Got new messages, Commander. You were on the ground with the Reaper. He fired up at us a few times. Joker pulled the Normandy through some insane maneuvers to stay out of the line of fire.
It's hard being in a fight like that, especially when you're not the one flying the ship. Joker's one of the best, though.
At first I was nauseous, swinging around in my safety harness. But then I was furious. Just enraged. I wanted that thing dead.
You didn't want the Reapers dead when they attacked Earth?
I wanted them defeated. I wanted Earth saved. But I never wanted to physically tear them in half and watch them blow up.
Congratulations, trainer. I believe you've discovered your fight-or-flight instinct.
Perhaps I should have stayed with Chess. Although now I think I'm spoiled by the lack of explosions.
Have done pretty well with those suits. Maybe they can make something like that for you.
Yeah, they have. Protective medical exoskeleton. I could even get one with racing stripes.
So what's the problem?
Well, it's like walking around in heavy armor. It totally screws with my spatial awareness.
I wear heavy armor, and my spatial awareness is perfect.
You crashed the last shuttle you flew, Vega. I need to feel my balance shift when I'm flying. I need to feel the ship moving with me. You take that away, I don't know. I mean, I'm good, but I'm not me.
Yeah, I get that.
Plus, have you seen Tally? Come on, I don't have the hips to carry a suit like that. So a Prothean, a real live Prothean. Has Liara stopped bouncing yet? I'm guessing there may have been some bouncing.
It's on your mind, Edie.
I was just reflecting. The Quarian's historical era was not making the Geth enough like them.
I'm not sure I understand.
Units with networked intelligences will trend toward cooperation for mutual benefit. But units with central heuristics establishing an individual personality, such as myself, develop preferences. These preferences form attachments that keep my calculations from devaluing the worth of the lives aboard the Normandy.
You're saying the Geth turned on the Quarians because they aren't individuals?
That is my theory. But it is limited to a sample size of one society. The only other notable synthetic society is the Reapers, and we do not know if they govern by consensus as the Geth do.
Do me a favor. Don't ask them. Trainer, if you're not doing anything, I've got a few hours free. Would you like to come up?
Your cabin is gorgeous. I've seen apartments smaller than this. Oh, an actual shower. The faucets in the women's bathroom are crap, by the way. Well, Commander, ready to play?
Play?
I picked up a chessboard on the Citadel. GUI interface, not nearly as nice as real pieces, but this takes up less space. And I recall you delivered something that closely resembled a challenge. So, interested?
This is a trap, isn't it?
I'm just a simple lab scientist, Commander. I'm sure your real-world expertise will give you an edge.
Ha! Oh, come on!
My word, Commander. It's almost as though you wanted to spare your pawns the indignity of living under my regime.
In real life, that tactic would have worked.
Well, in real life, one doesn't move on an 8x8 square grid.
You know what I mean. The pawns are infantry. A good infantry line like the Krogan can take a charge like that.
That reminds me of a joke. What's the difference between Commander Shepard and a Krogan? One is an unstoppable juggernaut of head-butting destruction.
And the other doesn't have a smart-ass comm officer to keep her in line.
Ooh, that's even better than the number of testicles punchline.
I'm glad you didn't run back to the lab, Trainer.
Thanks. So, rematch?
Hell yes. Trainer, can you send up Diana Allers? She wants to talk to me.
She's on her way, Commander.
I'm sure you've got a million questions.
I narrowed it down to 40. Let's see how you do with the top 10. Commander, the last time most of us heard about Geth, they were attacking the Citadel alongside Sovereign.
Yes, and you should know that was a minority of the Geth. Most of them are not hostile to organics.
Is that how you explain that they're allies, and no longer dangerous robots who stick humans on spikes?
What you have to realize is that despite their reputation, most Geth are not inherently violent. The Quarians attacked them. The Geth fought back in self-defense just like any organic would. Now that we've freed the Geth from Reaper control, they'll want payback for their enslavement.
But you're going to take an army of synthetics to fight Reapers with untold hacking abilities. What's keeping the Reapers from reprogramming the Geth like they have before?
The Geth are extremely intelligent, and they've put incredible thought into solving this problem. They're not going to turn again. I'd bet my life on it.
Now here's a question from a Batarian on Omega. Commander Shepard, if the mass relays can be destroyed... So did I miss anything? Do you have any questions?
You gonna go file your story now?
Well, if you don't mind.
Go tell the galaxy what we've done. I could use some good news.
Aye, aye, Commander.
What do you think about our new yeoman, Ms. Trainer?
She's not a yeoman, she's a communication specialist. And you're barking up the wrong tree, Kenneth. You're not our type.
Can't be. No. I guess that's right.
Hey, Tally. How's it going?
Oh, sorry. I didn't hear you. I just got communication from the fleet. Sorry. From Rannoch. In the old days, I'd send any new technology I found back to the fleet. I should probably be doing that with the agriculture samples now. I don't know anything about raising crops.
How are your people doing?
It's crazy. The Geth are helping. Setting up housing, adapting power systems. They are doing in weeks what would have taken us years. Geth are even uploading into the suits of Quarian volunteers. They're rewriting environmental functions, jump-starting our immune systems.
That doesn't seem possible.
The Geth are software, not hardware. They can transfer themselves from a normal body into anything with enough processing power. They're mimicking infections, so the host can adapt without getting sick. It's like making a vaccine.
So the Quarians won't have to wear those suits anymore?
It doesn't seem possible, but yes, in a few years, with Geth improvements, we won't need them. We might still wear them. The suits have become part of our society. But a rupture won't be a death sentence. Today, on Rannoch, there are Quarian children who will grow up healthy and strong, thanks to the Geth.
They owe that to you.
No. I'd have killed the Geth with no regrets. And I'd have been wrong. Thank you.
Anything, Commander?
What do you think of Edie?
We had a good talk during the retrofit. A little strange at first, talking shop with an AI.
AI? I thought Edie posed as a VI to keep the likes of you from unplugging her.
Yeah, but I saw through her. Have you seen her hardware? Processing power is off the charts. And then there were the problems that kept fixing themselves. If I hadn't had her pegged, I would have sworn I was losing it.
You never expressed any skepticism, Lieutenant Adams.
I figured I'd better play it safe with the Cerberus AI, Edie. No offense.
None taken. As long as you keep your fingers out of my cognizance processors.
In the beginning, I tried disconnecting her from key processes without giving myself away. Easier said than done. But Joker seemed to trust her, and in time I saw her advantages. Even grew to like her.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, ma'am.
Another Reaper has died. You are proving that humans are capable soldiers. But I question this peace you have brokered. No such thing is possible between machines and organics. I would have destroyed the synthetics without hesitation. And these Quarians, let's just hope they are reliable allies. It is difficult to trust a species that hides behind masks.
Folding chair or something.
another Reaper gone, and peace between the Geth and Quarians. It's amazing.
And now my people have a world to fight for. Something they know will last forever.
So long as you and the Geth remain good neighbors.
They're not our servants anymore. I'm not sure what we should call them. Allies?
Friends?
There's still too many wounds on either side. But maybe one day.
The Migrant Fleet and the Geth warships have joined Admiral Hackett.
Shepard, never a dull moment when the Normandy's on tour, is there?
Any word from Palavin?
Some, and I don't like what I'm hearing. The Krogan are there, in force, but they're just slowing the Reapers down, not stopping them. I'm not sure it's going to be enough.
Hear anything from your family?
But I did hear from Primarch Victus. He wanted my advice on fleet strength when the Crucible is ready. Still can't get used to people asking me things like that.
What did you say?
I said, at some point, we're going to have to decide if our fleets keep defending Palavin or we go on the offensive.
Can't do both.
Not with the beating we're taking. Like I said, not the sort of questions I'm used to answering.
You know what you're doing, Garrus. Trust me. Everyone can see that.
Maybe. But you spend so much time on the outside trying to get in, and when you do, it's not what I expected.
How so?
All the questions, and every one of them with a million lives riding on the answer.
You do the best you can with what you know. It's no different than your days at CSEC.
You're right. Though I'm starting to understand why the galaxy needs cold-hearted dictators every now and then.
They get things done?
They don't give a damn about the consequences. Suppose that's what it's going to take, Shepard. The ruthless calculus of war. 10 billion people over here die, so 20 billion over there can live. Are we up for that? Are you?
If all life in the galaxy vanishes because we hesitate, what choice do we have?
This is going to be a rough war. Peace between the Geth and Quarians.
Who would have thought?
Not how I ever imagined that would turn out. Next, you'll be telling me the Krogan and Turians are cooperating. Oh, right. You managed that one, too. You're a peacemaker, Shepard. A rare thing these days. Now, if you can pacify the Reapers, we'll make you a saint.
It's nice to have Tally back. I've made sure we're well stocked with dextro-based antibiotics and antihistamines. Hello, Commander.
I found something. Signal confirmed. Evasion successful.
Commander.
I found something. Reapers eluded. Thank you. Signal confirmed. Faster than light jump successful.
Thank you.
invasion successful. I found something. Reapers eluded. Faster than light jump successful.
You're cleared to dock, Normandy. Do you need ground transport?
I'm headed to Purgatory.
We'll have a cab ready for you.
I recovered the Code of the Ancients from Dakuna. It's waiting for you in Bay D-24.
With shock and joy. Really, this is wonderful news. Thank you, human. Sincerely, this will greatly aid our people.
Will your new heavy armor keep you safe? I've watched reports on some of the things you're fighting.
Well, it won't stop a Reaper, but...
I recovered some texts from a library in Reaper-controlled space. I can have them waiting for you at Bay D-24 if that would help.
Really? Well, damn, it couldn't hurt. Thank you. Maybe those texts will help the Asari remember how to fight again.
Like the Geth plasma shotgun, the Spitfire is not a true energy weapon. Instead, the minigun magnetically flings clusters of superconducting toroids. These donut-shaped projectiles are designed to shatter upon impact, arcing electricity between the fragments and flash converters.
Recognized. Please select a destination.
One moment, please.
Now arriving at Huerta Memorial Hospital.
Excuse me. I recovered the rings of a loon. They're waiting in Bay D-24.
That's wonderful. Thank you. My people will treat this miraculous find as a call to support their local hospitals.
Reaper forces have been sighted underneath the system within striking.
Spectre status recognized. Please select a destination. One moment, please. Arriving at Docking Bay E-24. Emergency... Civilian housing.
Hey there.
Hey. They'd come get me, no matter what they had to do. But it's been so long.
I don't know, kid. I'm sure they'd be happy, knowing you're safe.
It's just... I miss them. I miss them so much.
Ah, shit.
I found a Prothean sphere on Gay Hinnom. Contact the Alliance and tell them Commander Shepard asked them to pay you for it.
Yes, thank you. I'll call them right now.
Are you kidding me?
Recognized. Please select a destination.
One moment, please.
Now arriving at Presidium Commons.
I've recovered the obelisk of Karza. It's waiting for you in Bay D-24.
You have? It's amazing! Thank you, Commander. That's going to help immeasurably with some very sensitive work.
This is a nice spot, Ash.
Yeah. All the shuttles zipping around remind me of when my dad would get ready to ship out. My mom would bundle us all up, buy us ice cream, and cart us out to the shipyard to watch his transport depart. I still have to resist waving every time a big Alliance ship flies by.
You should bring Sarah up here.
I will, when she's ready. She'll like the quiet. She wasn't the loud tomboy crashing around like I was.
Sounds like you were a handful.
Maybe. My dad got me. Shame you never met him. He would have liked you.
You think so?
A badass military woman? Definitely. He would have tried to use his irresistible Williams charm on you. My mom would have laughed until he waved her away. Yeah. Yeah, he would have invited you over, cooked you something on the grill, and talked your ear off.
Ever think about what life would have been like outside the Alliance?
Oh, sure. Tried to rebel against the whole military family thing when I was growing up. When my dad and I got into it, I'd threaten to run away with the next guy that came along.
Really?
He'd laugh and say, "Good, I'll pack your damn bags myself." That tended to deflate me pretty quick. He knew I'd never stray far from the family. They're everything to me.
It's easy to forget what we fight for.
Yeah, moments like that.
This was a good idea.
Nice to get away from the war for a while. I do feel a little guilty, though.
Sure. But sometimes you have to step away or risk going crazy.
Too late.
No argument here.
You're a crappy commander.
You're a crappy commander...
ma'am.
Copy that.
Thank you.